goes where no man has gone before. The new iRobot Scuba 230, the floor washing robot, cleans awkward spaces and difficult places. It's time to let the robots do the work for you.
What's happening? Brien Tong here, and welcome to the Apple Byte for all the good and bad stuff inside the world of Apple. You know what this week's show is all about? Apple fanboys and tech enthusiasts everywhere can all agree it's the end of an era after Steve Jobs announced his resignation. Now, in his letter to Apple's board of directors and community, Steve wrote, "I've always said if there ever came a day where I could no longer meet my duties and expectations as Apple CEO, I would be the first to let you know. And unfortunately, that day has come." Steve Jobs will remain active at Apple as chairman of the board, and interim CEO Tim Cook will now succeed him as Apple's new CEO. Now, no one will be able to replace Apple's visionary and number one salesman, but don't get too worried. The Big A's roadmap has probably already been planned out for the next 5 years, and Jobs plans on being involved in developing major future products and strategy. But let's take a moment to recognize the man who revolutionized the PC industry, the music industry with the iPod, and digital distribution with iTunes, the smartphone industry with the iPhone, and the post-PC era with the iPad. Now, he also won't let Flash play on that same iPad, but come on, we're gonna put that aside, and let's just remember some of the moments that we've shared.
And sometimes when we touch, the honesty is too much, and I have to close my eyes and hide. I wanna hold you till I die, till we both break down and cry. I wanna hold you till the fear in me subsides. Romance and all the strategy.
I told myself I was gonna cry, but okay, I'm good. Now, we shouldn't overlook his impact on the movie industry with Pixar's stable of billion-dollar hits and Apple's impact on the retail industry with the highest sales per square foot. That's better than Tiffany, Coach, and everyone else. Now, the day after, newly appointed CEO Tim Cook sent a letter to Apple employees obtained by Ars Technica to rally the troops, saying, "I want you to be confident that Apple is not going to change. Steve built a company and culture that is unlike any other in the world, and we are going to stay true to that. It's in our DNA." So we'll see how much of SJ's DNA will really be able to help carry the company into the future. Now, Apple's all about its products, and we talked a whole lot about the iPhone 5 last week. According to the Wall Street Journal, Sprint will be offering the iPhone 5 when it launches later this year in mid-October. Now, the report says it will debut at the same time as AT&T and Verizon, and Sprint will also be picking up the iPhone 4 as well. In addition to that, MacTrass is also reporting that the next-gen iPhone will be coming to T-Mobile USA as well, which would bring the iPhone to all four major carriers in the US this year. Now, at least one developer has found evidence that confirms Apple is testing apps with the next iPhone operating two distinct network codes from both Verizon and AT&T, pointing to a single iPhone model that's compatible with both GSM and CDMA. Now, also, if you want to learn even more about the man behind the Apple logo, which we've talked a lot about, Walter Isaacson's authorized biography titled Steve Jobs, with a cover as minimalistic as can be, will be coming out on November 21st, bumping it up from its original March 2012 date. And publisher Simon & Schuster says the biography will also include the resignation from Steve's point of view. Jobs has made no subject off limits for this book, compiling hundreds of interviews with SJ himself and the people around him, so we should get some juicy tidbits in there. Now, there's been so many things said about Steve Jobs and Apple, but we wanted to leave you with a clip from one of his recent keynotes that really gives you a peek into the heart and mind of one of our generation's greatest businessmen and a person who at one time or another has influenced everyone's experience with technology. Simply put, it's the end of an era. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys next week.
So I've said this before, I thought it was worth repeating. It's in Apple's DNA that technology alone is not enough. That it's technology married with liberal arts, married with the humanities, that yields us the result that makes our hearts sing. And Nowhere is that more true than in these post-PC devices. And a lot of folks in this tablet market are rushing in, and they're looking at this as the next PC. The hardware and the software are done by different companies, and they're talking about speeds and feeds, just like they did with PCs. And our experience in every bone in our body says that that is not the right approach to this. That these are post-PC devices that need to be even easier to use than a PC, that need to be even more intuitive than a PC, and where the software and the hardware and the applications need to intertwine in an even more seamless way than they do on a PC. And we think we're on the right track with this. We think we have the right architecture, not just in silicon, but in the organization to build these kinds of products. And so I think we stand a pretty good chance of being pretty competitive in this market. And I hope that what you've seen today gives you a good feel for that.
Goes where no man has gone before. The new iRobot Scuba 230, the floor washing robot, cleans awkward spaces and difficult places. It's time to let the robots do the work for you.